We usually think of just three states of matter, solid, liquid, and gas. But there are other states of matter we might even see in everyday life, but rarely notice. For example, if you heat up gas enough, it becomes plasma, which is actually the most common state of matter in the universe. Plasma makes up stars, lightning, and light in light bulbs. One state of matter, called Bose-Einstein Condensate, hardly ever occurs in nature and is very difficult to make in a lab.
Now, what happens when molecules
slow down?
Well, they get closer and closer together, and some unusual things can happen.
But you might relate to Bose-Einstein condensates. Let's think about it. Zero degrees Celsius is pretty cold. 0 degrees Fahrenheit is even colder. But 0 degrees Kelvin is as cool as it can possibly get. Absolute zero. In fact, we can make stuff close to zero Kelvin, but we can't get all the way down there.
Think of it this way. Here's the ball of air, right? It's pretty cold. It's connected by this tube to this clamp. And this clamp is connected to the base of this refrigerator. And the refrigerator's on the table, and the table's on the floor, and the floor's in the building, and the building is on the earth! So there's always a path for heat to get from the earth, into the building, up onto the floor, up to the table, into the freezer, down this rod, into the ball of air! There's no way for the ball of air to be completely separated from some source of heat!
But if we cool some atoms to, say, 1/1 billionth of a degree Kelvin, we get a Bose-Einstein condensate. We can use it to track gravity or magnetism with high precision, or store information for a quantum computer. So how can we get atoms to such low temperatures? Well, first, make some atoms cold as you can with a laser.
If there's an atom moving in one direction and it absorbs a photon moving in the other direction, that momentum gets transferred to the atom and that will slow it down.
And that's the key to laser cooling.
Then, trap those atoms in a magnetic field. If you weaken that trap just a little, so only one atom can escape, which atom will it be? The hottest atom, obviously. And that atom will take heat with it. It's called evaporative cooling.
Now we can repeat the procedure. We again apply an energy cut. And this time we can lower the threshold a bit, since the sample is getting colder.
If you keep doing that again and again, eventually the trapped atoms will be so cold, they won't even remember their separate objects. The atoms will collapse into one homogeneous thing, and probably call each other comrade. That is a Bose-Einstein condensate.
If you cool atoms far enough to extremely low temperatures, they undergo a very strange transformation. They undergo an identity crisis.
Okay, so that communism joke was pretty funny, but really, I think humans can really get trapped like those atoms. Let me give you an example from fiction I totally recommend. Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai! 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 Cobra Kai!
Cobra Kai! Cobra Kai! Cobra Kai! The original Karate Kid movie was an 80s classic about a karate kid, a bullied by a bully, trained by Sensei Kreese in his dojo called Cobra Kai.
Sweep the leg. You have a problem with that?
No, Sensei.
No mercy.
The Karate Kid beats up his bully and Cobra Kai falls apart. The second Karate Kid movie is okay. He beats up another bully in Okinawa.
Live or die, man. Die. Wrong. Oh.
And then the third Karate Kid movie is kind of weird. Sensei Kreese teams up with his old Vietnam buddy, Sensei Silver, and they restart their dojo, Cobra Kai, just to give the Karate Kid hell.
I was so hopped up on cocaine, revenge. I spent months terrorizing a teenager over a high school karate tournament. It sounds insane just talking about it.
Cobra Kai on Netflix is about the Karate Kid's original bully, decades after the first movie. The adult Karate Kid pisses him off, so the bully starts the dojo Cobra Kai all over again. I'll try not to spoil the whole story for you, but the bully's old teacher, Sensei Kreese, comes back and helps run the place.
The real story's only just begun.
Some kids leave Cobra Kai because it's not their style. Or maybe Sensei Kreese kicks them out for not being Cobra Kai material.
I want to introduce you to a friend of mine.
Oh, cool. What's its name?
I don't know. What should it be?
Clarence?
Clarence.
Ooh, can I feed him?
No, but you can feed him.
What does he like to eat?
He likes to eat Clarence.
When Sensei Kreese goes too far, even Karate Kid's original bully leaves Cobra Kai and joins the Karate Kid at his own dojo.
Cobra Kai needs to change. What you taught didn't work back then, and it doesn't work now.
What do you want to change it to? Something nice and snuggly like a blanket?
Then Sensei Silver joins Cobra Kai, and things go off the rails. Kids who aren't assholes have to leave, until eventually Sensei Silver even kicks out Sensei Kreese.
That's what you get for betraying your sensei.
You got him to come here?
I had to prove my loyalty. You wanted to get back at him, right? Well, here's your chance. You want to see some more?
Let him go. Now. We agreed to settle this at the tournament. And that's where we're gonna do it.
What happened to No Mercy? I thought this is what you wanted.
So, Cobra Kai started pretty cold. Strike first, strike hard, no mercy. But it got even colder. Step by step, the warmest people left. The senseis said that they were losing weak links, but let's be pretentious and metaphorical here. This is evaporative cooling.
It's okay to object. Who else objects? You're off the team.
Get out!
What?
I said out! Get!
Go watch Cobra Kai. But anyway, let's imagine a group of people. You can label them communists or capitalists or Trump supporters or Biden supporters. I don't care. Let's say this is a group of people who don't like potatoes. If the group repels people who do like potatoes, or even people who are neutral about potatoes, then there's nothing to stop the group from becoming more extreme. We hate potatoes. This more extreme group will kick out people who don't dislike potatoes enough and become even more extreme anti-potato. And on and on and on until the people who are left trapped in the group can't have identities of their own outside hating potatoes. No, 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 we're not about liking carrots. Sure, carrots are better than potatoes, but don't lose focus on hating potatoes. People in the group depend on the group for all the identity they've got, because Any extra identity would get them kicked out of the group, into a world they're afraid of, because people like potatoes there. And so a radical cult has been born, full of people who dare not step out of line, or else they lose all the identity they've got. Now that is a Bose-Einstein condensate in social form.
But in the Bose condensate, I'm everywhere at once. I've lost my identity. I don't know who I am anymore. I'm at rest, and all the other atoms around at rest, but they're not other atoms around. We're all just one great big quantum system. There's nothing else like that in physics, and certainly not in human experience.
How can we prevent this trap and avoid evaporative cooling in society? Well, a group which accepts some variety and diversity probably won't expel many people just for being different. A group like that is constantly changing, with branches interacting, agreeing, disagreeing, and having people entering the group as often as they leave. That sounds less like a Bose-Einstein condensate and more like, a liquid, I guess. A non-Newtonian fluid dancing on a speaker. Yeah, that sounds way better.
I have waited a long time for this. Joseph, no.
Yeah. Honk.
Before I let you go, I want to mention the Lotus Sutra. It's a story from Mahayana Buddhism I've talked about on this channel before, and I generally like it and think it's pretty interesting. But it's also quite controversial. One of the most controversial parts of the Lotus Sutra is in Chapter 2. Chapter 1 sort of invites listeners like you and me to join an audience preparing to listen to the Buddha. And then Chapter 2 has some of that audience just stand up and leave. The Buddha says nothing and just lets them go. But then he tells the rest of the audience, those guys were just twigs and leaves who left out of arrogance. That sounds a little Cobra Kai, huh? It's drawing a line between Mahayana Buddhism, meaning the one and only great vehicle Buddhism, and other branches of Buddhism, which Mahayana Buddhists sometimes call Hinayana, meaning small vehicles. Lots of people take offense at that, although the Buddha does say those twigs and leaves do have Buddha nature. They will be Buddhas one day. They'll just have to go through a few hell realms first. Take that as you will. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
By the way, I've got a Patreon at patreon.com/thinkster. I want to thank all these squidlings and elder squids. Thanks.